Now I am ready with the meditation techniques for the whole batch. The work is done. It's a huge job. Let us enter into the introduction. I'll answer all your questions, yesterday night's questions, and then enter into the next step. Since the eye is not necessary for the functioning of the body, then who is responsible for karmas? Who is actually facing the karmas? Neither anybody is responsible for karmas, nor anybody is facing the karmas. See, if you think you are responsible for karmas, you will face karmas. See what I am saying. In the ordinary existence, as you are now, you will connect thoughts and create your eye, which has no base, the illusory eye. That illusory eye will continue to suffer the karmas. The very base I am shifting. What you think as I, see, what you think as I only carries all conditionings. Only that carries that you are, you belong to this country, you belong to this race, you belong to this nation, you belong to this, you belong to that. The one beauty is Hinduism is the only religion. I tell you one thing. Hinduism is the only religion which says go beyond religion. That is the greatness. This is the only group, or this is the only master. The Hindu masters, rishis, are the only courageous guys who boldly say go beyond. We are here to liberate you. We are here to liberate you. This duplicate I, the false I, only that creates karma and that continues to suffer. Here, the very false I doesn't exist. So don't bother about who is responsible for karma and who is actually facing karma. One more thing. When I said that you are unconnected thing, with this I, with this truth, solve all your problems. Whatever problems you have, solve everything. And whatever you can't solve, previous question and give me. I'll help you to solve it. Actually, this one understanding will completely liberate you. By now, you will have like you should be a guy. I think most of you are looking like a guy. Don't think that there is something different. You are nothing. Don't think that suddenly you will have new answers. You will just like this only, live a liberated life. You will not be bothered about anything else. You will just flow. Nothing will touch you. Beautiful things will happen. And you will live just a pure, beautiful life. And you will live an ecstatic life, that's all. By now, you should be in that ecstasy. If you are not, then what stops you? Where you are stopped? Where you are caught, where is lacking, right and give me. Put your questions. I'll now answer. I'll do one more atom bomb, nuclear bomb. As Anand Maheshwara says, I am nuclear bomb because I am new and clear.
Forget about all those things. Now you should start talking about what you
need. Instead of that, Nana Sanji, that board I saw, you are without hair. You are looking very young. What is this? Is this now you are looking grown hair? And only that one board, was, the sticker was not clear from him. It was coming out. If you talk all those things, you will be wasting your time. Then what will happen? Actually, oh, then I will tell you about that. All right, go, go, next, next. Then who is the loser? You. All those things are like sign boards to go to the lead master. The moment you see the lead master, drop all the nonsense. Drop all the shastras. Drop all your things. Just go with this one understanding. Simply, you are in me. Can I hear the sacred carbon that you gave to me at the Lord in the scheme, Rashi? You can hear, why not? Sacred carbon, have a sacred growth also, I have no problem. It's not complicated by me. And you are completely free to wear any cloth and not to wear also something. I have no problem. If you want to wear carbon, wear carbon. If you want to wear sacred growth, wear sacred growth. Don't want to get, I have no problem. It's others' problem. It is others' problem. I have no problem. So if others have no problem, it is up to you. I have no problem. There is nothing to say to anyone that is not past connected thoughts or future connected thoughts. Could you just go into the silent retreat? Do not go into the silent retreat. Then you will again sitting there and you will be thinking what to do after leaving the retreat. After going away from the retreat, what to do you will be thinking. If it happens now, just be able to like this, that's all. See, if now the if you feel like I have nothing to say to anybody, I have nothing to tell, I am feeling silent, be silent, that's all. Immediately don't plan, let me go to the silent retreat. And again you are connecting. Again you are connecting. Don't do that. If you are feeling silent, just be silent. Could you just go into the silent retreat? Just be silent. That is what is the retreat. Would not that be supportive of our quest for enlightenment? Nonsense. Who has to quest for enlightenment? Don't see. You are having it. Again you are making a quest. Again you are postponing it. This moment you are already, there is nothing to be. There is no need to seek anything. Just have it. And all you need is only one thing. When you understand God, completely connected thoughts, there is nothing. I am already unconnected. By my very nature, I am unconnected. That's why every moment I am renouncing. Renouncing, renouncing, renouncing. See, you are having unrelated thoughts on you in the mind. Constantly you are having unrelated thoughts on you. Means what? By your very nature, you are unconnected. By your very nature, you are renouncing. By your very nature, you are unattached. That is why you are having constantly unconnected thoughts. At one moment you may have a serious thought. Without this I cannot be alive. I cannot survive. I will die. But after 10 minutes you will not even remember that. You will be thinking of something else and eating jelly. Means what? By your very nature you are announcing. By your very nature nothing can bind you. By your very nature you drop things. By your very nature you are unattached. So just understand that. The moment you understand, if you have cool effort, that beautiful breeze in you, you have got it. Over. Nothing else is necessary. Oh God. True. Constantly, whatever I try, I am not able to attach myself to anything. Try your best to attach yourself to Anandagata. There is another question on Anandagata. From grace to Nitya Advaita Anandagata. You say Anandagata is an illusion. Thanks to you. I experience it every day, many times a day. How can it be an illusion? You say you are an illusion. You are an inseparable part of me. As much as myself. Yourself itself is illusion. What are you talking about myself? Source of parts of whatever is your own. You think yourself. Sometimes yourself is taken away by that. Sometimes yourself is taken away by lust. Sometimes yourself is just resting. Sometimes yourself is enjoying. Sometimes yourself is in pain. Then how wanted to say, isn't this something solid? At least I am not interested in being part of that cell. If you want, let somebody else be part of that cell. I am not interested in part of being that cell. So, some thoughts are whatever. Each time I experience the Ananda, there is a really different experience. But each intensity is real, not an illusion. Yet, whatever you say is true. So, if you are now saying that all is an illusion, the only illusion or a different form of truth, it does not matter. Either way, I am enjoying myself for the first time in many years. Thank you. See, whatever has not this experiencer and the experienced, the person who experiences the experience and the for example. Now if I am seeing, there is a seer. The seer is me. The seeing is this Ramsavaruf. And the seeing is action. Send it to the experience. And the experiencer. The happening experience happens. If these three things are there, be very clear, it is an illusion. It's an illusion. When there is all these three disappears, all the difference or the idea which you have in head, see, whenever some spiritual experience happens, first thing, find out, are you able to differentiate between the experiencer and experience? If you are able to, be very clear, it's illusion, drop. If you are not able to, very idea of experiencer and experience doesn't raise in you. Just, it's there. If you are creating the word experience, experiencer, from the past experience you are correcting. Again, a cunning way of clutching the shaft. Maybe cold and shaft. But shaft. Including me, everything else, whatever you know as me is illusion. That is why I say, out of that illusion, whether you love me or hate me, out of the illusion, if you love me, there are so many letters, Baba, letters, God, and your eyes are pouring love, pouring compassion. I don't know what is pouring. Nothing is coming. And when you look at me, I just blossom. My whole being is jumping. Baba, Baba. And it's a nice chance, all these days, know that I am going to read personally. So, various and various are love letters. And what's going on, I don't understand. And no, I will not tell the names. Anyhow, dear Swamiji, as a memory, is memory a help or an impediment? The human chain connection or distant thing continue. Memory is neither a help nor it stops you. See. Is this mat help for you to sit here or it stops me to sit here? It's lying there. If I want, I can use it as help and sit here. If I don't want, I can throw that and be here. Memory is just a weapon lying there. If you want, you can take it and connect and connect and connect and connect and see and suffer. If you want, you can drop that and just be relaxed and connected and enjoy. Memory is no way touching you. While I was doing the exercise today, seeing outside without the personality, my whole body was shaking, trembling a few times. Then please tell me what was happening. Why are you connecting again? It was trembling and shaking. Let it tremble. What is that? Don't bother. Let it tremble. Means that really unconscious is happening. See, your body is nothing but what you believe as your mind. You believe your mind is a chain thoughts. When you are disconnected, your body is trembling. Oh God, then what am I, what am I, what am I? Your whole identity is moving away. That's why you are trembling. Actually, you trembled physically. You trembled physically. There are so many clothes who are trembling inside. Huh? And it is. Let it happen. Because you are unclutching. See, when you hold the clutch, you change the gear. When unclutching happens, there
that will shake me like that. That's that. That's what is happening now. I will expect to take care that you safely change the gear. My shoulders back are paining very much. I was really tired. My body muscles and joints looks like. I was entirely my body just within my body. One very good experience. Wanted to share with you. Good, beautiful one. Beautiful. You are really getting the Ananda Prasada. You are getting the Ananda Prasada. Prasada of Ananda is coming to you. Don't miss it. Catch. Today my meditation was disturbed by some people restlessly moving, talking, coughing by cell phones. Ringing immediately, a voice from inside myself was saying that I am wrong. One, that my meditation is not steady enough. Still, I am feeling the energy in the room was divided into two parts. First, who asked you to meditate? If you are meditating, then seriously wrong something. I ask you to just be. It's not meditation. Don't create the word meditation. If you create the word meditation, then you will get disturbed. Then you get disturbed. I have been very clear. All my yogis are bhutakanas. You will not decide. You will realize that I'm just the bhutakanas. You will not be silent. And I don't want that silence also. And one more thing, the energy in the room is divided. Energy can never be divided. Be very clear. If you feel energy in the room is divided, there is something in you is divided. So be very clear, don't meditate. Who asked you to meditate? And see, when you hear the cell phone ring, when you hear somebody shouting, you connect with your earlier disturbances and see, oh, that time when this happened, that's why I was disturbed. Now again it is happening, I will be disturbed. No need to connect. That time you were disturbed means that is different. This time is totally different incident. There is no need that you should be disturbed again by that. Cell phone. Outside thing will not disturb you, only inner idea it will disturb you, will disturb. Swamiji, can we say human being on the earth? Or hologram? Why are you saying all this nonsense? Who asked you to say it's all their holograms? Beloved Master, I think I jumped to the unknown space, finally where I reach. I don't know, but the path it seems so ecstatic, so blissful, but it seems I am missing or left out. Feel very fortunate to be born. This time now every moment is auspicious to me. O Master, you are the one and you are the guiding me to become the one like you. Be very clear. You are moving beautifully, but don't catch at this birth. Don't start talking inside. Oh, Master is so beautiful, he is so auspicious, he is so great. Then again you will bring back your mind. No. Just let that ecstasy happen. See. When the ecstasy happens, this gratitude which you are saying, this will automatically constantly overflow. It's actually a beautiful letter. You say that I took a jump to the unknown space, finally where I reach, I don't know. But the path itself is so ecstatic, so blissful. But it seems I am missing or left out. I feel very fortunate to be born this time. Now every moment is auspicious to me. O Master, you are the one and you are the guiding. You are guiding me to become one like you. Be very clear. I am not guiding, I am already guided. Over. Now simply you are one. Just simply be in that space. If you are in that space, that is enough. Gratitude will automatically flow. You will not write letter. You will just write your being. Your whole being will return to me. Your whole being will be given away to me. Nothing like a, what to say, nothing will be held. You will not hold anything back. You will just, your whole being will say you are in gratitude. Somebody asked me, why should we do Guru Puja? That morning they do Guru Puja. The morning all of you do Guru Puja? Attended? Somebody asked me, why should we do Guru Puja? I said, don't know. Who asked you? When the gratitude overflows, it is just an ecstasy. You don't even know what, you don't even ask why should I do. Do you ask why should I brush my teeth? Do you ask why should I take bath? Just like that, you don't even ask. You just overflow. You just flow with it. You just do the good. I always tell people, the moment you have a question, why should I do puja?
Don't do.
Because it is not done for some purpose. It is done out of overflowing. I don't know how to express my being to master. So at least doing this small thing I'll express. So you pour water. Whatever you get, you pour it under. Whatever you get, you put it under the feet of the master. It's like you throw things. I don't know what I can give you. At least, please have this. You throw water, you throw flour, you throw everything. That is what? The Guru Puja. It's Guru Puja is such a big cyclone has happened in you. You don't know what to do. And you are just exploding. Guru Puja is an explosion. If you are not exploding, don't do Guru Puja. I always tell people, you should be just exploding. You are just exploding every moment. You don't know what to do. You don't know how to express. So you express itself in the form of Guru Puja. Your very explosion is Guru Puja. Nothing else is Guru Puja. Nothing else is gratitude. Your very explosion is gratitude. Actually, the Guru Puja results have come. Whoever is exploding, see, be very clear. If something less than explosion, you will not be able to do Guru Puja. See, usually they ask me, Swamiji, you should tell people to do Guru Puja. I said, no. I will only filter whether can do or cannot do. I will not ask people to do Guru Puja. If they want to do, I tell no, you are not qualified to do. Go and do. I will not discourage people. I will not encourage them to do it. Set a goal of Guru Puja set. If you are really exploding, then you are qualified to do Guru Puja. You see, your being should be constantly exploding. You should become a nuclear bomb. Constantly you should be new and clear. That is, if you have nuclear bomb, then you are qualified to Guru Puja. That's all. Then you are qualified to Guru Puja. I tell you one thing. Honestly, Master's body is my body. My body is just like the administration. Constant explosion is going on. Constantly the explosion is going on. And it is just an administration. I always tell you to take care of me. Who take care of me, my food and my stay, all those things, my crew members, I always tell you. Constant explosion, that is why there is a standard instruction for me. Once I close my eyes, they should not touch me. Once I close my eyes, they cannot come near me. Because what's going on inside, I don't know. Only when my eyes are open, they can relate with me. And these days, they touch the door. When my eyes are closed, they have a good shock. And shout and run. It's a constant explosion. Constantly it's like an atomic power station. So let you be very clear. If you also become atomic power station, then you can do Guru Puja. Otherwise, you are not allowed to do Guru Puja. You are not qualified to do Guru Puja. Don't do Guru Puja without explosion. Then it's anti. I don't want your Guru Puja. Who cares for the Guru Puja? Be very clear. If you are exploding and don't know what's going on inside, what's going on outside, then do Guru Puja. That's what the mantra means. Hridbhagma asanam dadhyā. My heart is the asana for you. Hridbhagma means heart lotus. That is the seat for you. O Master, please sit. That's for you. Sahasra achyutam mṛtaihi vādyam saranayo dadhyā. When you are liberated, see, yesterday, if you are really caught up, whatever I said, your whole head will just feel so sweet. And your whole touch will be feeling so sweet, so nice. Your whole body is just in ecstasy. That ecstasy, that joy is amrita, which is water washed the feet. The water they offer is that joy, the explosion. When the explosion is going on, what joy happens to me? That is amrita to wash the feet. Hridbhagma asanam dadhyā sahasrār achyutām mṛtaihi vādyam saraṇayo dadhyā. manastu argyam nivedaye. See, manastu in Sanskrit, stu means which is dead. The mind which is dead already in me, that I offer as a flower. Not the mind is active. Not manaha argyam. Manastu argyam. Everybody knows Sanskrit? Little bit, then you can understand. The samasas of Sandhi is manastu argyam means what? Which is already gone, unpacked. Unpacked, which is not there. That is Arya, flower for you. Arya means flower. Manastu Arya Nivedaye. Not the living mind, not Manaha Arya. Manastu Arya. Then, Tena Abhujena Achamaniya. The explosion, that jaw is the Achamaniya. Water to wash your mouth. Then Abhijena Achamaniyam Snaniyam Venajasmadam. That explosion, that joy I am pouring as a bathing water for you. Snaniyam Venajasmadam. Akashadattam Vastram Syadam. Boundarylessness which I am feeling is the cloth for you. That boundarylessness which I am feeling, that only I am as a cloth for you. Akashadattam Vastram Syadam. Gandhasyadam Gandhatattam. This whole planet, I just take it and keep it as a saddle for you. Apply saddle, understand? Saddle on you. Gandhasya, Gandhadattam, Chittam Kadalpaye Pushpam. The Chittam means the old memories. Everything I am offering as a flower, take it. Everything is flower on you. This is the way the puja is done, Guru Puja. The starting of the Guru Puja, you are reciting this mantra only. Manasa Puja Mantra means it is not actually puja, you are just exploding. You are just telling me, I am exploding, I am exploding, I am exploding. I offer it to you, over. If you are exploding, then tomorrow I will start Guru Puja. Actually, when it explodes in you, your very presence is Guru Puja. Your very presence is Guru Puja. Be very clear. You will just answer when I am present. If you are present in my presence, you are alive. You being here, present in my presence itself is aragana. You are absent in my presence, then you are doing Guru Puja. Namaha means what? I am not. I am not. Namaha. I am not. If you are not there, then it is Guru Puja. If you are there, whatever you pour, it is only your ego. It is not Guru Puja. During the meditation, there is continuous movement over the skies and deeps. Sometimes there is a feeling of moving up in a giant gear. You are in roller coaster. What do you think you are? Why do you think I made such a big hall? But the visualization of the body lying on the ground is not possible. The low back pain and knee pain, pain pulls down. Be very clear. If the pain is there, then you are again connecting and seeing. Why do you connect and see? Don't stop connecting and seeing. To disconnect from the pain is a disturbance, but no. Why do you want to disconnect? Just see. You are connecting and seeing because of the lack of pain. Say this or because of your connecting and seeing, you are having pain. You don't even have to disconnect. Just know you are connecting and seeing. That's why pain exists. Effort healing from the pain we made or not. You should ignore it totally. Just make that. Understand you are connecting. Then automatically you will come. You don't have to even make the effort. Now, the important thing, next thing. Where you feel you are stuck. Where you think you are not able to understand this is connected. The whole thing is connected. Connection. Or where you think you are afraid to let go, understand. No, if I understand, if I accept this truth, then this will go away from me. This may go away from me. Sometimes you think, all my properties may leave me. Because I am unconnected, I will not take care of the property. Something will happen to something, something will happen to something. Somebody may take away my company, somebody may take away my business. You may have some fear. If you have the fear, put that as a question. Where you have fear, to experience this truth and live it. From today you have to live this truth. That you are unconnected. That's the truth. You are living. You you have to label. What you think as a hindrance, put it in writing and give me. Put your questions. Sit. What all you think as hindrances are fears. You are not able to let go. If you have no fear, nothing, everything is beautiful, then just be in the ecstasy, don't bother. Let the explosion happen in you. Don't even have the word explosion. It should be happening. You should not be having the word. Then again, you can have one more thing and create a problem. Even if you feel that it's happening at some time, it's not happening at another time, all those things put it as a question. Whatever doubt you have, or problem you have, fear you have, worry you have, bring it. So that I'll clear inch by inch. Sometimes even if you write, it will get clear. Then it's okay.